Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today, continuing with the series of the videos or tutorial of fine tuning an LLM for document classification with your own dataset. I'm recording this video in another version of the document similarity piece of the chain, of the LAN chain pipeline, in which I will use ChromaDB as a vector store, and I will use the framework Ollama to create embeddings. I did the test with a Mistral 7 billions and also with Llama 2, and I want also to show you how to set up Mistral, sorry, Ollama. It's pretty simple, and it's working. The good thing is working in my computer. I'm not using today Colab. I'm using my computer with a very limited GPU, NVIDIA 1650 with 4 GB memory, and you will see how this works with this. Well, pretty impressive. Let's start. Again, today I'm working with Jupyter Notebook in my own computer, so you will see how this can be done with a relatively big model like Mistral, especially for a computer, for a personal computer, or Llama 2, how they are running in my computer, how they are creating embeddings. Even you can generate this. We will see this in a different tutorial to explore all the capabilities of Ollama. And then, well, for those that watch previous videos where I was doing exactly the same that I'm going to show today, that where I took the classes, the purview classes, and I create embeddings from there, and then on take an arbitrary document and compare, create embeddings as well for that documents, and via the document similarity functionality that comes with the vector store, classify the document versus one of the top most likely class, or the top 5 most likely class, or top 10 most likely classes. And then on most of this stuff was explained in previous videos, so I will not go very in detail through this. I will assume that you saw the videos before from this series. Later on, I will put anyway a link to them on the description of the video. So anyway, we start import the libraries. Everything is already installed in my Conda environment, so I will not show this again. It's already explained. I take the CSV file with the description of the PureView classes, together with some additional details I add using a DuckDuckGo search. I include some additional details or instructions how to identify documents that belongs to any of the classes in Microsoft PureView. Remember that we have 59. Here I just creating a new attribute in the data frame, which is essentially the original description provided by Microsoft, and together with what I get from DuckDuckGo engine. So here, let me check it. Okay. So here I'm just serializing finally to a CSV file which has two columns. One is going to be used as a text to create a LangChain document, and the other one is going to be the metadata. Sorry, metadata is going to be classifier, and detail is going to be the text or the page content attribute in the LangChain document. And classifier, which is the class I will be using, I will be including that as metadata on the LangChain document. I just check some checks for the, let me run this again, taking a while, I don't know why, oops, sorry, yeah, I need to simply read it again, I did it already. Okay, data column, length, 59 classes. We take, we open the CSV, the pandas data frame with the CSV loader from LangChain, and then it should remember everything that we include on metadata columns is going to be to the metadata attribute of the class, and the rest will be included on the page content. As we only have two, details will be the page content and the class, which is in classifier column, will be to metadata, will go to metadata. So we load it, document, it you get the classifier, and well, here we are getting just the attribute classifier of the dictionary. This is the whole dictionary, this is the page content. Page content, as I said before, is the result of the original class, original description from Microsoft Purview, together with a search that I did in DuckDuckGo, an automatized search, looking for instructions on how to identify documents of this category. I did as well some things in previous tutorials using an LLM, a Mistral 7B instructor. And then, well, it's just a way to enrich the description of the category, and how to the model identify the data document belongs to this category or not. Leno documents, LangChain documents, 59. Okay, so we work again with ChromaDB. ChromaDB, for those that didn't show videos before, is a storage, vector storage, pure vector storage. This is not a graph database like Neo4j. It's just doing the job. It's just taking a document, you create an embedding of the document, and store both in the database, in the vector database. For embeddings, you can use any model available. I try with Hugging Face, with OpenAI, with now you will see samples with Llama 2 or Mistral, so well, it doesn't really matter. There is no limitation like it was with in Neo4j, which I had a limitation of maximum 2048 dimensions of the embedding vectors. Here we don't have it. No, it's a very small database, freeware, under the hood is working with MySQL, sorry, yeah. No, SQLite 3, I will show you later, because we persist the database to Dix in order to reuse it in the future, no need to create the database again. And well, here we have the documentation, the integration with LangChain, again, also any components I enter in these videos are fully compatible and integrated with LangChain. And if you saw videos before, everything well is quite, there is a lot of possibilities in LangChain, a lot of technologies that are integrated directly with them, and the advantage to use these classes, these integrated, these wrappers to which integrates different technologies, as that is that you have a common interface, and then it has plug and play a new component. It can be a vector database, any of the things that you have here, and then all these technologies have a common interface, so you manage them using the same commands. They have a common set of the commands and attributes that that are shared across all these technologies, regardless the category: embeddings, document loaders, document transformers, vector stores. And then each of these categories there is a lot of technologies that have integration with the LangChain, and all of this use the same interface to interact with them. Then on also each category had the it may have their own attributes, but in any case this is specific for that specific technology. For example, you may have in Azure OpenAI, I don't know, define the region or a specific parameter for something that you can only do in Azure, but this is specific of the class. And among all that, there is the common procedures and common parameters that are shared across the whole category, then the embedding models. This is really an advantage, and then it allows you to plug and play to say components very quickly and experiment with different options up to you find something that is suitable for the requirements of your project. Olama is nice. Well, I discovered this technology not long ago, and well, it's also a framework which allows you to experiment with multiple LLMs very easily and fast. No, it's just another technology plug and play. Also integrate directly with LangChain and with other frameworks. You can install it in Mac or Linux or Windows or System Linux. This is where I have it installed. It's in Windows still no support, but probably it's not a big requirement to do that, because usually when you run this kind of projects or you make usually you create application which runs in Linux or exactly Linux. Dockers in Linux is usually what you use. Well, in any case, I'm running this in as I said in my machine in Windows or System Linux version 2. To install it, pretty simple. Is you just run this in a common command line. Let me show you. And once you after install it the Olama, you just get you have the application already installed, and you can interact with this via command line. You need to start this Olama. Essentially, in few words, is kind of the application server which expose the different LLMs that you had installed via endpoint, and then you have endpoints to create embeddings, you have endpoints to generate this different endpoints. We will cover all this stuff in a different video. This is not today the purpose. We are going just to see I'm going to show you how to use this as a technology to create embeddings and do the same that we did with other technologies, but this time with Olama and using two different models, Mistral and Llama 2. So to run the Olama framework, you just execute the Llama serve, and I usually send this to the background, and this start the server. No, again, you will be interacting with the model via endpoint, sending a request to an endpoint via POS. You will see now this how to create it. Also, is available a Docker. If you prefer to go directly with Docker, this is something I will try soon. also con directly with you can set that NVIDIA support to work with GPU. I highly recommend you to do that because it's not is working a little bit slowly. Well, slowly in my computer again because I'm trying this on my computer in a Windows System Linux. It's a Debian 9 and again it's my machine is not very powerful. Probably you should try the same in a VM in the cloud in Amazon or Azure or Google. It's gonna be fast, no? But in here in my machine, if you don't use the GPU, it's running a little bit slow, no? So case in my case, I didn't have to set up the GPU. I had the Windows System Linux ready to work with the GPU I had on the computer, so I didn't have to follow this procedure and just installing Olama. It recognized that you have a GPU and it use it. It's you instructed to do that. No, I will show you now how to do it as well. And again, later to work with a specific model, there is a list of them. Let me show you. In this library, you have plenty of models available. It's impressive, to be honest. All the models that you have available there. So Zephyr, which is a fine-tuned version of Mistral. Really a lot. Falcon even, which is a very big model in comparison with Mistral or Llama. A little bit old, but well. Here in generative AI, all is 1 year, or 1 year and a half. Okay, so you can decide which model you want to use. Again, I did try test with Llama 2, with Orca Mini, and with Mistral. All of them, you need to, when you want to run a specific model, you just execute this command, and this command will check essentially to have the model locally downloaded, and then it's not, it will download it from Hugging Face. Done simple than that. I'm not gonna do it, but again, you just go to the command line. You can do the same this as well via post request, sending a request to the Olama framework. But again, we will see this in a different video. For now, I run the command Olama run Llama 2. Olama run Llama 2, Olama run Mistral, and Olama run Orca Mini. And then this allow me later on here to when I create the vector, the embeddings, not to download it again, no? So here I just create a path to serialize the vector store embeddings and documents. I create the object. This is the LangChain object to create Olama embeddings, similar to others that you saw in the previous videos, like OpenAI embeddings or Hugging Face embeddings, whatever we use in the, or even, let me think, I think I have, yeah, I think here is the one of the previous notebooks I use. So here, if you see, we use. Here we use Neo4j, but yeah, we will try with OpenAI, GPT-4, and we try as well when we record the video, the Neo4j as a vector store. We try with Olama embeddings using an Orca Mini, but the problem we had at that time is, as I said, Neo4j. When you use it integrated in LangChain as a vector store, doesn't allow you to store embeddings with a size of more of 2048 dimensions. Okay, we create the. We are going to use Llama 2 in this case, And now just simply Chroma for, we create as well. This is a common method for all vector stores. It's just take the documents, LangChain documents, give me the embeddings class, the embedding object you want to use. Here we send a specific parameters to the vector store. This is only for Chroma. I'm telling the vector stores that use cosine similarity to verify or to verify the how close are documents when I do a query, when I send a query to the vector store, use cosine similarity. In case of the of Chroma, I think it was somewhere else, user guide, where I have this. Once I'm getting started, it's not wrong here, you had a reference. User guide, collections. Yeah, so you have different metadata you can use via this attribute. In the vector store you can use SQL to inner product or cosine similarity. By default it's using SQL 2, and then I want to use in this specific test cosine similarity. It's important to understand this because it's not you can see some how to say strange output that sometimes makes no sense, and then every vector database or vector stores have their own specificities, so you need to look at this in order to understand exactly how the database compare different vectors, so how to match different vectors or the embedding vectors, no? So we just run the model, and so okay, now start to create the embeddings. Let me show you how is working that. So as I said before, it's interacting with the application server. I suppose it's using either Flash or Flash API behind. And well, it's pretty simple. It's just sending POST requests to this endpoint, and you see every request is preparing to send 59. We are using again the documents. What is doing essentially this this method is sending the document we created before, the LangChain document, storing the whole document on the vector store database, and then on creating the embeddings or see using OLAMA framework and the model LAMA 2. Everything use the same interface, pretty simple to understand. Plug and play, you plug another model using the same code, and you had embeddings created with another LLM. As you can see here in my machine, every embedding is taking round about 5 to 6 seconds. This even using a GPU. Well, for this test is acceptable. Probably in a production environment this will be very slow, but again in a production environment suppose that we will have a better infrastructure. I'm going to stop this here. Once it's finished, I will be back. It's gonna take 6-7 minutes after we create all the embeddings. But well, as you can see, it's pretty simple to use this technology. It's using my GPU. I didn't have to do a specific setup, just install it. But it's true that I had already configured my Debian, my WSL version 2 for with NVIDIA support. So probably that help a lot, no, in this situation. Okay, let's make a pause. I will be back in a couple of minutes. Hello, I'm back. So this has finished. Finally took, as I said, round about 7 minutes. Now we are gonna test, with, like in other videos, with simply tests that we introduce in this variable query and we send to the database to do cosine similarity. This will produce as well just one embedding, as you see here. It's just we are doing. We are encoding the test, producing an embedding, and now is producing, is finding, or is matching or comparing the test versus all the embeddings that it has on the database and return the top five more close documents. In this case, classes for us as we are doing similarity. And what you can see here is well. Is speaking about German Airlines, Lufthansa, returning profit, employees stock, financial bank, bank statement, manufacturing batch record. Well, here it we call the embeddings. We get in other, if you are using other technologies, you will get here the model itself, the instance of the model that is producing embedding. In this case, as the model is wrapped behind an endpoint, it's just sending you all the details and the model that you are using on the OLAMA interface. So we are not sending any specific parameter, as you can see here, repeat the last one, repeat penalty. There is multiple parameters that you can say to send to the model. You can go to the details, or we will, anyway, we will look at this in a different video where we will speak only about OLAMA and the different models. Here we call another methods. As I say before, these methods are common across all the technologies that integrate as a vector stores with the LangChain. So that is the real advantage to use this framework, this library. And well, here you have another relevant score, similarity with relevant score. This is one minus cosine similarity. So what is? And that's it. If you like it, thanks for watching. If you have you are following my channel, if you have something that you would like to me to speak about, or something that you find interesting, or some mistake that well, I'm not perfect, far from being perfect, for sure. Some of these stuff bugs or something that I didn't say correctly, just write me a comment on the video. And again, if you want to me cover something specifically in which you are interested, just let me know in the channel as well. And thanks for watching again. And if you like the content, just give me a like. And if you didn't subscribe, it's now time to do it. Thank you. See you soon.